due to the huge amount of feedback and comments I got about my last video on Scottish Borders waterfalls, I've decided to make a long overdue sequel. And I'm beginning today back here in Galashiels. I said there were no waterfalls in Galashiels. Well, I've been put firmly in my place by a lot of people, so I'm going to find some Galashiels waterfalls first and foremost today. Come with me. Wilder Hall area of Galashiels right up in the north on the A7. Looks like an old mill lead or something there, I'm not sure what that was about. This is the start of the waterfall here in Gala, just falling down from the A7. But apparently the main part of it is a bit further down, so let's go and see if we can find that. If there was ever a bridge saying, please don't go on me, this is it. Let's go. I'm alright, sorry, fine. I wouldn't advise you going out that bridge. I'm afraid this is it. Gala's once great gushing waterfall has been reduced to a mere trickle. A nice wee tunnel here as well. Tommy! Tommy! Are you in there, Tommy? God knows where he's went this time. Yeah, that was quite disappointing. But I think the next one in the Galashiels area might be a bit more spectacular. There's a little burn which runs through the small village of Cloven Ford near Galashiels, or Cadden Foot. Inconspicuous burn, you wouldn't think much of it, but apparently there's a quite dramatic waterfall around here, so I'm up here looking for it today. Foot just outside Galashiels. Who the fuck? Wow! This is nearly the first drop in a whole series of falls. It's quite spectacular. It really is rather spectacular here and well worth a look, and it's very hidden. I've been in Cloven Fords and Cadden Foot millions of times and I've never ever seen this before. But I know what you're thinking. You're thinking that's more of a rapid than a waterfall. We want something more, something bigger, something better. Let's go and see what we can find. So there you go, Cadden Foot Falls, what a surprise. But you're probably like me and you're thinking, I wonder if any world famous 18th century English painters painted the depictions of waterfalls on the borders. Somebody like, I don't know, Turner? Surely no. Well, I can tell you that Turner did paint a waterfall on the Scottish borders, and it was in the Galashiels area, and that's what we're going to try and find today. Up at Colshiels Loch, there is a place called Rymer's Glen, a mysterious place which Turner visited in 1834 and painted a waterfall up there. Is it still there? Can we find it? Let's see. So Turner, world famous English artist Turner, who's painting himself for millions and millions these days, made a series of paintings here in the Scottish borders. And one of his most famous paintings is of a waterfall in Rymer's Glen, which is just at the other side of Colshiels Loch here. Rymer's Glen here was part of the Abbotsford estate owned by Sir Walter Scott. That's why Turner was here. He wanted to paint the places that Walter Scott had talked about and visited. And Rymer's Glen is a magical, mysterious place. The haunt of Thomas the Rhymer, the famous Scottish Borders prophet. A place filled with fairies and mysticism. Unfortunately, however, in the last century, the picturesque Rymer's Glen with its waterfalls and little bridges was kind of destroyed by forestry, conifer plantations. But just recently, these plantations have been felled and the whole area has been exposed again. So that's why I'm here today, to see now if we can find the mystical Rymer's Glen waterfall painted by Turner in 1834.
So we left Colshiels Loch and ran and ran and ran and ran and ran, headed for our destination of Rymer's Glen. But what met us was a scene not of picture postcard beauty, but of almost post-apocalyptic devastation. The forestry clearance had not made the area more accessible and viewable, but created an almost desert wasteland where nothing was alive. The glen could still be seen running through the area, but it was not of any scenic beauty. In fact, the only scant remains of Turner's waterfall were this almost pathetic, bare, exposed trickle of water through the muddy, barren wasteland.
So there you go, progress, and particularly commercial, financial progress, stopped for nothing. But my quest to find magnificent, majestic waterfalls on the Scottish border stops at nothing either. And that's why I've came down to Craig Forest, deep in the heart of Teviotdale, to find the legendary Wolf Cleuch. Wolf Cleuch. The name clearly harks back to a time when this area of the Scottish borders was inhabited by wolves. It's not the only place in the borders which has wolf in the name, so clearly it was quite a common animal around these parts. is extinct. This forest covers a huge area, but I need to find this waterfall. It's not going to be the easiest. I think I'm nearing it now. I'm beginning to hear the water cascading over the rocks here. Wow! 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 It's amazing! Wolf Cleuch! Better than Stitch Hill even! Do you know what? It's so good. I think I'm going to give it a flying without wings montage.
Find it in the deepest friendship, the guy you cherish all your life. When you know how much that means, you found that special thing. You're flying without wings. So impossible. Cause they're missing. You got to fight for every dream. Cause who's to know which one you let go.
Wow! It was worth the trudge through the bog and forest and marshland to get here. Cause it's quite simply awe-inspiring, amazing. You must come up and see it. Who's that? Was that the fabled Wolfman of Wolf Cleuch? Hope not. But there you go. Another breathtaking, huge Scottish Borders waterfall. And probably even more hidden than Stitch Hill. You need to be really keen to find this one. Let's make it a tourist attraction. Get people up to see it. Because you don't see many like that, I can assure you. I wonder why it's called Wolf Cleuch. I wonder who that strange looking man lurking about in the shadows was.